team champions.
Texas is about to get loaded! Hello everyone, my name is H.J. Stewart, and usually you'd see me commentating for IFW Action, but tonight I have the absolute privilege to commentate for Loaded Wrestling! It is an absolute honor to cover one hell of a matchup because tonight we're coming straight off the hills of an amazing Elimination Chamber event! In the main event of the Elimination Chamber of Blood, Kuro Takahashi, that man right there, walked away with the Loaded Wrestling Championship, but that is not the Loaded Wrestling Championship. That is the WWF World Heavyweight Championship. That's the same title that Kuro walked away with 3 years ago. I gotta be honest, it's kind of disrespectful to the name Loaded Wrestling. I mean, you have guys like Eduardo Escobar, Kobe Benjamin, and Nathan Smarter, who pioneered for that very title, who gave that title a meaning. It was Kobe Benjamin and Eduardo Escobar who went face-to-face to determine the first ever Loaded Wrestling Champion. And then you have Nathan Smarter versus Eduardo Escobar, who went head-to-head in a 60-minute Ironman match, and they put each other through hell, through tables, through chairs. They beat the hell out of each other in that Ironman match for that very title. And here's Kuro saying that it doesn't matter. Maybe he's giving the title back. Maybe he's claiming this title as the new world title here for Loaded Wrestling. Whatever the case is, Kuro has absolutely been on top of the world as of late. Made his return into SPW and here in Loaded Wrestling. And he is now reclaiming the SPW World Championship at Supreme Star 6. He cashed in the Destiny Championship and ended Nathan Smarter, his own protege's 425-plus game record of holding the title. And now Kuro looking for a new future here in Loaded Wrestling. Let's see what he has to say.
Yeah.
gauntlet has been laid down. Kura has challenged Nathan Smarter 101 at Legend 5. Quite possibly the biggest Empire event in history yet. Legend 5 is in the making, and we already have one match officially announced. We might have a second here, Nathan versus Kura. Only time will tell, but right now, Nathan needs to leave Kuro's mind for the moment. Because as he's circling the ring like it's his yard, and it might as well be, it's stunned. The older brother of Gwen Hatcher, who absolutely put on a show at Elimination Chamber. She might have been the first one eliminated, but goddamn did she go out swinging. And who's to say Stumps can't do the same? If Stumps can absolutely pick up a win here on Ricardo, maybe even give him hell in this match, he might deserve a championship opportunity in the near future. But that's later on, and this is now. The bell has been rung. Here we go. Kuro laying into it with those padded elbows. Stump with a big arm drag counter to boot to the face to follow through. Kuro walked out of Elimination Chamber after defeating five other men and retaining the title. Can he do the same thing against this man right here? Wait a minute, Kuro counters, ducks under, and hits him with a Pele kick. Kuro's got him covered with the leg hook. Styles has his hand on the rope. What the hell? Wait a goddamn minute. Did that just happen? Styles had his hand on the rope. The referee might not have seen it, but his hand was on the rope. Did I just hear that? I did just hear that. I know that bell anywhere. I know that infernal bell anywhere. It's the calling card for the very protege for Colonel Takahashi. For the former, oh my god, the former Loaded Wrestling Champion and the leader of a cult where I'm from. It's Nathan Smarta. And something tells me he's gonna be directly answering the challenge that Kuro has laid out. I've never seen him summon this hellfire before. So it's a new thing to me. Maybe Nathan has more power than he is letting on. But he does not have enough power to get the job done as of late. Because as of late, Nathan has become an absolute stepping stone. And I have done it. He's taken a loss in more ways than one. He got thrown off the stage by Mikey Truth. He had his head slammed in a door by Mikey Truth. And then his own Blackbird cult lost their new enemies. Then you got SPW and he lost the title. And then you're here, he couldn't regain his Loaded title.
Applebuck season ended a long time ago when I burned down Sweet Apple Acres and made my nest for the Black Bird. How dare you question me as the franchise? I've been clawing my way beyond your teachings, beyond the future that you paved the way for.
Tear his head off.
I have been carrying my family name better than anyone in my family or your family could ever do. I started a revolution in this empire. I crucified the idea of hope and became a god. And yet you don't see me as the franchise.
Put him in a body bag!
That shouldn't surprise me. From the moment you left me alone in that dojo, from the moment you walked out of OWF, from the moment you beat me down in FZW and betrayed me with a false black bird, you left me to die. But a true black bird was my saving grace. She resurrected me. She made me reborn. And I have found haven in her wings. And together we have given life to more baby birds. If it wasn't for all your mistakes, Kuro, I would have never met the true Blackbird. I am more than just a gimmick. I am more than just the franchise. I am Nathan Smarta. And I'm the man you'll never beat face to face.
Your beard's stupid!
Come, loaded legend. I'll make you hail Smarta one more time.
The challenge has been accepted! Nathan has accepted the challenge to go face to face with current legend! Although he's accepted, that is not the official match! That is still to be determined! But what is the first official match for Legend 5? It's the unbeatable, the undefeated boxer, Dennis Parker, taking on the newly signed Sheldon Mondo! Sheldon Mondo's looking to break the streak at Dennis Parker. Can he do it? There's only one way to find out. But that's Legend, and this is Now. We have a lot of action for you all tonight. Later on, we have Rip making a huge announcement here tonight. We have the undefeated Dennis Parker taking on Enadine. And right now, it's time for the continuation of the Loaded Wrestling Tag Team Championship Tournament. So far, already, we have many competitors, including No Remorse Mafia, who've been appearing in more ways than one here in the Empire. And now we have two, count of two, newcomers. First up making his way is Bad Luck Buck. Bad Luck Buck coming all the way from Japan after Stanley Pack has injured his own counterpart here in Bad Attitude Brandon. Best of luck to Bad Attitude Brandon over in Japan. He's led a successful career so far. Hopefully he can keep improving it. And maybe Bad Luck Buck is looking to get a measure of revenge here tonight. Buck is going to be taking on with another newcomer by the name of Graham Nicholson. And they're going to be taking on the returning legends, the Cats! Kenny and Stanley Cat are back in action after having a year plus of issues. But now they finally put it all aside and they're going to be reunited as a family, as brothers should be. The 10-year veterans of the ring are back on the road and looking to capture the gold. And now making his way to the ring is Graham Nicholson. Graham Nicholson is an old school wrestler. Coming straight out of the 80s, looking to make a big name for himself once more in 2020. Best of luck to both of these newcomers here. Both to Graham for making a return to wrestling here. Being a big name in the 80s Empire, looking to make a big name for himself in 2020. Good luck to him. I can't wish too much luck to a Bad Luck Buck, because I don't want anything negative to happen to the returning veterans here in the Cats. And here they come! 10 years together! the family remains stronger. Kenny and Stanley Cat coming all the way from TNT to SPW, to OWF, and now here in Loaded Wrestling. It is an absolute amazing sight to see these two back together. For them to put their issues aside has got to be the best possible thing for the family. Stanley Cat obviously sporting a wound coming from Elimination Chamber. He took a beating, but he's here tonight to take more and possibly become tag team champions after the tournament. The bell has been rung. Here we go. Bad Luck Butt is starting it off, and already the disrespect has begun to Stanley Cat. Stanley might have injured his counterpart in Japan, but Bad Luck Butt is coming for revenge. Big neck breaker to start it off by Stanley. He's got him covered. One, two. Not even a two count. Stanley showing the disrespect right back. He's not finished with him just yet. Stanley, look at him pounding, beating away at Buck here. The Cats have been what? Oh my God! Stanley Cat is back. Wait a minute! What the hell? What the hell was that? I was getting so excited to see the Cats fighting for the tag titles again. But Stanley, no, you gotta be kidding me. Are you serious right now? Stanley just pedigreed his own partner and left him for dead at the hands of a Buck. I can't believe this. The Cats, they just put their issues aside. And yet here we are again. The challenge has been laid out, and Legend Fun is starting to look more and more loaded! Serve up has issued the chance to Hypnosis! Will he accept the chance to gain control of Loaded? We are back here in Fort Worth, Texas! And things are about to get interesting! The unbeaten, the undefeated, the absolute monster that is Dennis Parker. Dennis Parker is scheduled to take on Sheldon Mondo at Legend 5. But tonight, he's going to be taking on the newcomer in Anadine. Anadine has tried to make himself known here in London Wrestling, but every time he gets taken down by someone from behind. Speaking of being taken down from behind, it's Sheldon Mondo! Ow! Sheldon Mondo just sent Dennis Parker face first into that railing! Sheldon Mondo just got a contract with London Wrestling! And he is starting to use it to his advantage. Oh my God! Face first into the post! Sheldon Mondo is absolutely on the attack here. Dennis Parker was supposed to take on Anadine. But Mondo doesn't give a damn. He's beating the life out of Dennis Parker right now. It might be a shortcut to try and beat the undefeated. And how can Legend 5, this tactic might just work because Dennis Parker wasn't ready for it. Dennis Parker trying to roll out. He's trying to catch his breath at least. But Mondo's not stopping. Look at the power of Mondo. Parker finally got at a clothesline. Parker finally got. Wait a minute! Parker! Wait, this is going to extreme! This is going to the extreme! Wait! Oh my God! Enough already! He's pounding his chest in with that steel steps! You can end his career like that, damn it! What the hell? Well, it seems like a change has been made here. Anadine needs a new opponent. He's found one in Van Sisley. Hopefully things can go a little bit better than just a moment ago. Oh my God. I'm sorry, but I mean, if on one hand, it's Sheldon Mondo's fault. He tried to gain the upper hand rather early for Legend 5. And yet it backfired huge. It backfired in a huge way. Dennis Parker literally picked up that steel steps. And he dropped it on his chest. He caved in his chest with that. You can end a man's career like that. You can stop his heart like that. God! I'm getting word here that Sheldon Mondo has been taken to the local medical facility here in Fort Worth. We wish the best of luck to Mondo. Oh my goodness. Dean Michaels has sent home Dennis Parker for the night after that altercation, taking it a little too far. Self-defense or not, he could have ended the career of Sheldon Mondo like that. They won't redo for Legend. That's supposed to be a huge match for Legend. Dean Michaels is gonna cover more on this later. If you'd like more information and more late-breaking news here that I can't get to at the time, please check out facebook.com/loadedwrestling. My goodness. I mean, the action we've seen here tonight already It's only gonna get better, I can trust. Because Van Sisley Jr. and Anodyne, excuse me, Anodyne, no disrespect here to the man. The very mysterious Anodyne here. We've seen much of Van Sisley Jr. laying in that karate kung fu style, laying his opponents out in each and every way he can, but we haven't seen much of Anodyne because every opportunity he has to make a name for himself, he gets taken down by someone from behind. As I was saying before, Sheldon Butler came out and did his Parker. Seems to me that Sherlock has charged hypnosis, but he's currently still suspended by Dean Michaels from attacking Sherlock. But at the same time, hypnosis has become the IFW World Championship. He's gained the IFW World Title by showing up and taking on Asbury's challenge at IFW. He's become champion. And now I gotta think, along with some others back here, the rumors are swirling like bees up back here, that Dean Michaels wants to bring Hypnosis back before he decides to stay in IFW for good. Dean Michaels better do something quick because Hypnosis became champion on the spot. I mean, he delivered absolute punishment to Asbjorn of IFW, and he gained the championship immediately. Good luck to everyone involved here in Legend 5, Surf Up, Hypnosis, and Dean Michaels. Hopefully they can get that all sorted out. Wait a minute, editing here. Both of these men are going underway here. I'm sorry for ignoring their match for the time being, but we have... A lot of things have been going on back here. I mean, between Mondo getting attacked, Koro challenging Smarter and accepting it, these two going face-to-face as a replacement match. It's a hell of a replacement match. Anodyne finally being able to showcase his skills here tonight against Van Sisley Jr., someone who can match his skill. Instead of just being attacked from behind by the three wise men as of late. Look at the training of blows between these two. You gotta think they're both coming with their A-game. They both need a win in here. They've both been on a losing streak. Anodyne has been a big deal, but has yet to prove himself. Van Sisley Jr. has had a world title match against Smarter, and yet it has been his biggest match. But he took a loss in that match, and he has never been able to regain that same fire since that match. Maybe he can get it going here. Maybe he can get it going in fact, but I don't think that might be the truth. Because Anodyne's got a count on only a two count. These men are going back and forth. Look at this. It's a pin as well. He's got a cover. Arrogance is not going to get you too far if you can't back it up with skill. Van Sisley challenging Anodyne to follow him outside the ring, and it looks like these two are meeting each other's minds way too well. Sisley now has Anodyne on the ropes quite literally. Sisley over the top, counters with an elbow. On top with the springboard, he misses the knee. But that neckbreaker doesn't miss a beat. Anodyne gearing up for something huge here. Sisley sitting in the corner like a duck. And I did charge it through. Oh, but he countered again. Sisley got him down to one knee. This could be absolute trouble. Oh, what a shot to the face of Anodyne. And another headbutt to the stomach. I don't know who's taking more of that damage. Sisley with the headbutt or Anodyne to the sternum. Oh, my goodness. Anodyne, big counter on that kick to the face that Sisley was looking to get out for. These two have been absolutely evenly matched. Look at this submission hole that Anodyne has on Sisley. Just wrenching at the legs, putting the pressure on. Rock actually gets out of it. Wow! Turns him around and goes face first. Around a mask first to the knee. And he's got him with that reach, a Saturn hold. Sasha's got him. Wait! These two are breaking out of everything. Entity! Ah! Got red suplex. Looking to put a finishing touch in his hair on Sisley Jr. Oh, the throwback is in effect here. Anna Dean absolutely feeling himself here tonight. Wait a minute, you can't make that. He made that. Not only did he make that, he jumped out over to the heart of Matt Sisley Jr. He's got him covered. Two. Only a two count. Distance. He jumped clear across the ring with that elbow drop. And then he gets a kick in the face for his troubles. Sisley, he got a covered leg hook. And that is all. What a match between Sisley Jr. and Anna Dean. My goodness. What a match between those two, and maybe this is the turning point for Van Sisley Jr. And Anna Dean has definitely proved himself here tonight. But it's a victory for another time. Look at this! All the way across the ring with that! I'm getting an update here. Kitty Kat was backstage. Having a bit of a breakdown. It's sad to see Kitty Cat's been throwing stuff back here. And Stanley has left the building has been seen with a smile on his face leaving the building here tonight. I can't believe Stanley did that. He absolutely ruined the Cat's return again! Again! Time we've seen that package. I don't know what it means. It might be something big for the women's division here. It might be something huge for Legend 5. But we've had an amazing night already. And I think it's about to get the best that it's gonna get. Because we have the ever resilient, the breakout star for Loaded Wrestling. It's Rip. Rip has been making a huge name for herself here in Loaded Wrestling. She's been through battles with Nika Nikita. She's gone through hell in that Extreme Rules match that she had with her. And now she's looking for something bigger from what I hear. Rip is looking for the opportunity of a lifetime here. I'll be damned! Rip is looking to go to the next level! She's challenging for the Featherweight Championship! Speaking of the Featherweight Champion, there she is! Someone who's also defended her title at the Elimination Chamber of Blood. Outlasting five other women here. White Stone is still the featherweight champion. But will that remain when Rip gets her hands on it? White Stone has been an absolutely defending champion as well. I mean, White Stone was the one who defeated Megan Foster of IFW Homegrown Talent. Gave her hell in that ladder match to regain that very featherweight title. But Rip is not Megan Foster. And Rip is also not one of those five women that White Stone outlasted at the Elimination Chamber. It looks like we just got a jam-packed main event here. White Stone isn't handing over opportunities too easily. Looks like Rip is going to have to be in a three-way dance. Best of luck to Rip and along with her other two competitors here. Rip is going to be taking on Tiana Tucker and Marty T to determine who can go up against White Stone here. Coming up first is Marty T. Explain the rules of a three-way dance. It's rather different than a triple threat match. In a triple threat match, participants battle it out in a furious battle until one person, only one, gets the pin or submission. The champion can get pinned, the non-champion can get pinned. The triple threat is exactly a triple threat. A three-way dance, however, these combatants are gonna be fighting in a non-stop contest until there's one woman standing. It is elimination style. A triple threat usually is one fall to the finish, but this three-way dance, it can go as long as it needs to until there is one remaining wrestler. According to Dean Michaels, this match has also been made into an extreme rules match. So the best of luck to all three ladies, because Rip definitely already has the advantage going in. No disqualification. You gotta eliminate your opponent. Now this is gonna be a freeze for Rip. But let me not speak too soon. Because any one of these ladies can come up the winner. And when they do, they'll be taking on White Stone in the next episode for Loaded Wrestling. Tiana Tucker making her return here to Loaded Wrestling under a new style and a new demeanor. Hopefully this new style can bring her more victories than she could have before. Many people have reinvented themselves here in Loaded Wrestling. Many have tried and failed. Many have succeeded very well. Best of luck to all those who have. This three-way dance has begun and already Rip laying into Marty T here. Tiana Tucker taking advantage of it. Rip taking advantage of that. Countering Tiana Tucker and laying out both of them. Big elbow to the face. That was disgusting. And a chop to the chest. Rip laying in these strikes here to Tiana Tucker. Tucker now missing with a slap roll. Both of these ladies are a little bit dazed and confused here. I mean, hell, they all, If you haven't seen Elimination Chamber already, you can definitely see why everyone's been putting through hell here tonight. Everyone might be a little dazed and confused after that Elimination Chamber event. Big bulldog by Tiana Tucker. And Marty T headed onto the apron and Rip trying to roll away, trying to get a catch her breath here. Trying to take a moment to catch her breath, but it doesn't look like Marty T or Tiana Tucker are trying to face off against each other here. This is Elimination Rules here. And I would imagine that the best idea would be to target someone. But Marty T just took a high risk and it did not pay off. And Tiana Tucker laying in the shots to Rip here. Oh, what a shot. The fans are getting more for what they paid for here. Wait. Ah, some more double team action on that thin padding on the floor. Those pads are paper thin. They're just there to help you walk better. But landing on those things is just like landing on concrete. And look at this. They're absolutely destroying Rip right now. They're just trading their back and forth behind that ring post. Ah, they bounced her skull off that post. Tucker now has Rip by the hair. It's as legal as possible because this is Extreme Elimination Rules here. Oh, and a big leg drop over the throat of Rip. Rip has been through absolute hell here in Loaded Wrestling. But I don't think she's ever been through hell like this. She's getting double teamed here. Look at the strength of Marty T. A big body slam and Tucker. And elbow drops are falling through. Slide is not stopping. A big drop kick to the back. Tucker laying in the punishment even more. Tucker going high risk. Big arm drag. Marty T on the second rope and a big moonsault. One of the best moonsaults I've ever seen. These ladies are not attacking each other at all. At all. They have been focused in on Rip. Something doesn't seem right here. Something seems fishy. White Stone set up this three-way dance. And Rip was the only person who asked to have an opportunity here. And now she's getting help for it. Wait a minute. This ain't looking good for Rip. This is not looking good for Rip. Both of these ladies are still chained. Rip is getting thrown down in the ring with Chaz here. This is just insanity. She's getting her ass beat. We've seen people go through hell the whole night. We've seen a meeting of the minds with Anna Dean and Dan Sisley Jr. We've seen Sheldon Martin get his chest caved in. Still no word on what happened with him with that. But definitely the most punishment of the night has got to go to Rip. Because she's getting destroyed by these two ladies. Yes, this has been a setup. Are they going to fight it out? No, still, this is an absolute setup by White Stone. Whitestone absolutely set this match up for Rip to downfall. I think Whitestone is afraid of Rip. Look at this. Look at the power of Tucker bouncing her head off those steps. I'm surprised we still got those steel stairs out here. After the damage that Sheldon Mondo went through by Dennis Parker, I'm surprised we still have steel steps. And these ladies are just ongoing. Rip is dazed and confused. I don't even think she can fight back. She probably has concussion from the steel chair shot and get the head bounce off the damn steel steps. This is a three-way dance for elimination. And yes, it can be said it is the best idea to target one enemy. But this is just ridiculous at this point. Any one of these ladies can be pinned, and yet they have not fought each other except Rip. Look at this. Rip trying to walk away, trying to catch her breath as much as she can. My goodness. I don't need to put her through an absolute hell in the Extreme Rules match with thumbtacks, barbed wire, steel chairs, ladders, you name it. They did it all in that match with Nika Nikita. But wait, Rip! She finally gets the chair away from her! Tucker! Oh, God, Rip needs to fight back. She's trying. But she's gotta be concussed after those chair shots. After everything she's already went through before and now. Rip has gotta be feeling everything. Oh my God! Just rope-a-dumping Rip. Just, oh my goodness! No way to protect herself. She landed on a goddamn hang and again with a steel chair by Marty T. How long will this match go on? Ah, a steel chair. Thank you. Now get rid of the other one. She's been through enough already. Tucker, Famouser, laying out Rip here. Put her away already. You've done enough. This is absolutely defining. This absolutely tells me that they set this up this way. Martin. Oh my God. An impressive European uppercut on the Rip. There we go. There we go. Martin T taking out Tucker. She just removed the competition. Oh, wait a minute, Rip. She's got a hooked up. She's got a leg. She's got a rolled up. That's what you get. Marty T just got eliminated by Rip. Rip might have been playing possum there. Marty T just got eliminated. And White Stone's title might be in more jeopardy. Because Rip is coming back with a vengeance hand. Tiana Tucker is going to be paying for some sins here. Rip absolutely laid out Marty T. She rolled her up and pinned her. Ah, chain to the gut. Tiana Tucker and Marty T have been beating the hell out of Rip this whole match. And now it's time for some retribution. Big leg drop by Rip. Maybe she was concussed, maybe she shook it off, or maybe she was waiting for the right opportunity to score one over on both of these ladies. And that's gotta be something White Stone has to be careful of. Rip is one of the most resilient women in Empire history. She's been through nightmares scarier than White Stone. Speaking of nightmares, I think Tiana Tucker is about to face the ultimate nightmare. Tucker is about to go rest in peace. She's got her leg hooked. One, two, and Rip is the number one contender for White Star Featherweight Championship. Rip has been through an amazing year. And it looks like she's looking to end it with a featherweight gold. Come next episode. Ladies and gentlemen, it has been a pleasure to call Loaded Wrestling's action here tonight. My name is HJ Stewart, and before I go, I've been given word that the suspension has been lifted. Hypnosis is back in Loaded Wrestling. We'll see what he has to say on the next episode. Thank you all for watching. Good night.